Mr. Chairman, distinguished members of the House, I'm Sheriff Mike Lewis, the Sheriff of Wicomico County. I'm the current president of the Maryland Sheriff's Association, and I serve as co-chair of our legislative committee, which meets once a week. As a lifelong resident of Wicomico County and an avid hunter and fisherman, my views are certainly stronger than some others. However, I echo other sheriffs when I say I oppose any law and regulation that infringes or restricts a citizen's right to protect himself or his family, which is a true reason for our longstanding Second Amendment right. The Maryland Sheriff's Association has agreed to work with Governor O'Malley and our local delegation on many issues regarding gun safety and public safety. I agree with these common sense points of discussion, which identify the real issues associated with gun control that do not infringe on a citizen's right to bear arms under our Second Amendment. As a 28-year veteran of law enforcement, 22 years as a Maryland State Trooper, and now 6 years as a sheriff of Wicomico County, I have a distinguished career in both gun and drug enforcement across our state, with thousands, not hundreds, of street and highway arrests under my belt. I'm very proud to say that I have been that grunt in the trenches, and I feel qualified to say that proposed House Bill 294 will do nothing to reduce, suppress, or stem the flow of gun crime on the streets of the state of Maryland. I've never arrested and charged a person for a gun crime where the gun was legally registered to them. The guns were often stolen, sold for drugs, including marijuana, and now we're even trying to legalize that. Do you really believe these proposed feel-good laws will reduce any crime at all? I've heard testimony here today regarding the number of law enforcement officers killed in the line of duty. According to the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial in Washington, D.C., for two consecutive years, law enforcement officers' line of duty deaths have plummeted. In fact, there are more law enforcement officers killed in automobile-related crashes than are killed by gunfire every year. And that has been consecutive for the last 9 years. Due to Maryland's lack of vigorous prosecution of gun crimes and Governor O'Malley's determination to abolish the death penalty, along with this new proposed legislation, there is tremendous incentive today for criminals to move to Maryland to resume their criminal activities. Our law-abiding citizens, now discouraged from legally purchasing a firearm due to these proposed hurdles, can only stand by and watch these criminals flourish in their old profession of terrorizing innocent citizens. What this bill won't do, this bill will not keep certain restrictive firearms out of the hands of criminals who intend to commit a crime with a gun. This proposed legislation will not keep violent repeat offenders incarcerated longer for the crimes they now commit with guns. This will not deter or prevent acts of violence involving guns. This bill does not change the current concealed carry law to enhance personal protection rights of our citizens. These are nothing more than feel-good proposals that do absolutely nothing more than impact our law-abiding citizens and undoubtedly make our law-abiding citizens victims of those criminals who will continue to steal, rob, rape, and murder while holding a firearm to your neighbor's head. This morning on the Senate floor, I listened to Senator Raskin, a constitutional law professor. Just this morning, while aggressively arguing for the abolishment of the death penalty, he stated it has been proven that the death penalty does not serve as a deterrent to those committing homicide, no more than the passing of this legislation will do to prevent gun violence in the state of Maryland. Yet we are proposing legislation that will certainly affect the safety and security of law-abiding citizens while remaining hopeful that these criminals will now abide by our new laws. This is an outrageous insult to the American people. I swore a solemn oath to protect and defend the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of Maryland, and I'm prepared to stand my ground with my constituents for the preservation of its traditional interpretation. Thank you.
Delegate McDonough.
Mr. Chairman, I thought this question would have been more appropriate for the governor, but I think it might be appropriate based on your testimony. I think this bill is dishonest because I don't think it really covers gun violence. There were 195 murders in Baltimore City last year. 70% were committed by convicted felons on parole. Maryland has the highest rate of early release of convicted felons of gun crimes in the United States. Nobody in the press, the governor, nobody wants to talk about that. Now, I have a bill which I'm going to convert into a amendment to this bill. It's House Bill 424. And what that bill does is it says that if you commit a crime of violence with a gun, there will be no early release, no parole, and no plea bargain. You will serve your time. In Baltimore City, that would have turned the murder rate into 65 instead of 217, but 195 by gun. Now, in your opinion, is that an important part of this whole debate on gun violence and this bill that is being left out?
I certainly believe it is, sir. Absolutely. On October 17, 1995, Trooper First Class Eddie Plank was shot and killed during a traffic stop in Somerset County, Maryland, shot through the face with a 45 caliber handgun by a three-time convicted felon, a man who 14 months earlier had been convicted of cocaine trafficking with a firearm and sentenced to 12 years in prison. And 14 months later, he was out and he killed a Maryland State Trooper. 13 weeks after that, I made a traffic stop on U.S. Route 13, got into a struggle with a convicted felon with two previous armed robbery convictions, both with a firearm. We fought for control of my weapon, and I ultimately had to shoot and kill him. If we were to keep these individuals behind bars where they belong, we'd be a much safer society and enforce the current laws we have on the books. That's all we're asking. We do not need new legislation.
Well, this General Assembly, every year, including last year, they created a new college within the prison system that allows criminal violent offenders, except for murders, which my amendment prohibited, to go to that college free of charge and as a result to get early release. And I think the mentality is inconsistent and somewhat hypocritical in this General Assembly, that if you are going to always promote legislation for early release and at the same time claim that you want to prevent gun violence, that there's somewhat of a bit of hypocrisy there. Would you not agree that this legislature can't contribute to preventing gun violence if every year it contributes to part of the problem, which is early release?
I certainly do agree, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your time and your testimony
Thank
here
you.
Today.
Thank you.
Let's bring up the next panel.